In this video, we'll discuss the sections of your account settings.
Jump to a specific section by using the timestamps here.
Access Account Settings. To access your account settings, first click on your name, then Account Settings. Profile. In the Profile section of your account settings, you can add or change your photo and your display name, your first name, your last name, and your country. You can change your password and set your preferred language. If you need to change your account role, contact support. You can also view organizations that you belong to. By clicking on the red button to the right of the icon, you can leave the organization. You can also change your role within the organization. Scrolling to the bottom, you can click to join a school. If you can't find your school, you can add it here as well. If you scroll to the very bottom of the page, there's a red button that you can delete your account. Notification preferences. In notification preferences, you can view all your devices associated with your accounts. You can turn them on, off, delete them, and also add devices to your accounts. You can set your call preferences and your message options. You can set office hours by setting a start time and an end time of your day and the days that you work. Messages can still be sent outside of office hours, but a pop-up will appear letting the person know that they are doing so. App integrations. In app integrations, you can view apps that have been connected to your Remind account and disconnect them. You can also connect available apps by logging into them. Widgets. Widgets can be embedded into class websites to show recent communication over Remind. You can choose the class that you would like to share and then copy the link or copy the widget code and then place it into the HTML of the class website. Message history. In message history, you can export a PDF of the announcement that you've sent to participants in a class by choosing a class from the dropdown and then a start date and end date of the messages. Click export and you will receive them via email. You can also export a PDF of the participants in the class by selecting a class and clicking export. Under exporting user data, you can request an email link of all the data associated with your account. Archived classes. In archived classes, you can view classes that you have archived previously. You can unarchive them, or you can select to reuse the class code. You can also view your current classes and archive them here. Blocked users. In blocked users, you will be able to see a list of people that you have blocked from your account. You can also unblock users by clicking on the button next to their name.